Hey dolls, so today I have another DIY, and this is the final DIY of 2018, and it's this gorgeous diamond version of those popular boxes, flower boxes, rose boxes that you see on Instagram. They call it eternity boxes, eternity roses, forever roses. There's so many names for it, but this is my version, which is diamonds, because you know I love all that glam and beauty and all that kind of stuff. So no one has ever done this before. This will be the first time you're seeing this, and I'll be showing you how to make it. And I think it's so expensive looking, and it's such a must-have for every glam girl's bedroom, office, anywhere that you just want it in your space, apartment, home, just anywhere, even in your kitchen or in the bathroom will look gorgeous as well. So if you want to know how I made these gorgeous diamond eternity roses boxes, they also call it a million roses, so many names, they even call it the Instagram flowers because they're made popular on Instagram. If you want to know how to make it, grab your coffee, grab your tea, and let's do this DIY video. And if you're new to my channel, subscribe down below and also give this video a big fat thumbs up and share it with your friends. And Valentine's Day is coming up, so make it for someone you love. So first I got my boxes from Hobby Lobby. No, actually Joann's. Hobby Lobby sold out, and I got this one actually from Hobby Lobby, the white one. This one here's from Joann's, and it's just a hat box or gift box. And I got a medium size, and this one was like $10, but with 40% off I got it for like $7 something. I'm doing two. I'm making one for my friend, so she's gonna have the squared one while I have the round one, and you can make many different sizes. This will be such a good like display for a bridal shower. That's what I'm thinking. So here's another view of the boxes, absolutely perfect for this DIY. I mean, everything you need is here, and I'm going to be spray painting them because of course we don't want this brown look, unless, you know, that's what you like, but of course that's not why you clicked on this video. So we're going to be spray painting them so they can kind of just give the, it can just make the crystals pop. We're going to be spray painting them silver. I'm going to be using this Krylon spray paint because it gives it a metallic finish. So just underneath, if it's going to show silver, in case any of the crystals kind of fall off or anything, the underneath part would look good, the base will look good. So I'm just going to spray paint. Here is my box and it's already dry, ready to go. Some parts of it were still kind of wet, but whatever. And don't worry if it's not spray painted perfectly. We're going to be covering all of this with crystals. The inside is going to be covered in flowers, so no one's going to see if it's done well. The only thing I was sad about was the top, because I'm not going to be putting crystals on the lid because it's going to be on the bottom. So, but no one's going to see the top because it's going to be glued down anyway. And some of it wasn't sprayed well, but no one's going to see all this stuff, so it's okay. So you would need a glue gun, and this is my glue gun I'm going to be using here. You would need some foam. I got this from Dollar Tree, however you can get this from Hobby Lobby, and I just cut them in pieces so they can fit. You would need flowers. I'm not sure if I want to use that one there, but I'm definitely using this one. It's because of that yellow. I don't want it with the pink, the yellow inside. I just love those deep pink ones and I feel the yellow is going to kill it, and I just want to stick with roses actually. And you need ribbon. You would need crystal sheets, which I'm going to put the link below. I got this online and you can get this on Amazon or anywhere online, but I'll put the links to the seller I got because they always ship on time and they always give me good quality. You would also need some, you can do two contrasts of different roses. I'm going to do light and dark. This glue is the best glue ever. It's a spray adhesive and it just sticks instantly and it's just perfect. It does run a bit pricey, $10, but I mean, it's okay. You can use it for other projects as well. So definitely get that. It's the best thing for this, but it just gets sticky, I must warn. So I already pre-cut my strips of crystal mesh or whatever you want to call this. Before I got on camera, so I cut them. I just kind of measured it against the box and cut round it, and I already did that off camera. So I'm now going to just be showing you how I glue on camera, which, bear with me, I have one hand on the camera holding the camera and one hand doing this project, so it's gonna look a bit messy as I'm doing it because I'm trying to literally do a juggling act of balancing two things, one being a camera, one being the actual project, and also with a sticky hand of glue. As you can see, there's just like spray paint everywhere, so bear with me, but I'm sure you get the idea and the whole concept of what I'm doing, because it's very clear even though I'm struggling. As you can see, I'm trying to like hold everything together so you can see it on camera. So spray, and don't spray too much. You don't need that much, and then you just want it to get tacky. That's where you don't want it to be wet. If not, it's gonna slide, your crystal will slide off and not want to stick. So don't spray too much, which I learned the hard way. And a warning, it does get sticky. It literally got all over my nails, but it's now off my nails, which is good. But then I don't know if that's because I have gel nails, but shellac nails. I don't know if that's the reason why, but it's off my nails. Like, it didn't stick overnight, basically. So you're just gonna, sorry, my hand is in the way and all you're looking at is my freckles on my hand. So as you can see, I put too much on this one, so it's sliding. So you need to do it really carefully. This glue does stick really fast for some reason to this crystal. They just work so well together. So you need to kind of move really fast, but at the same time don't rush because you don't want it to be messed up. So I'm using my hand to press it down, and I must warn, the edges, you're gonna get a little bit of, like, you know, if you didn't measure it right, you're going to get a little bit of leftover on the edges, which I'm going to cut off. And then also there, if you do get, see, I need a little bit more glue, but if you do get like stuff coming up at the corners, just use a hot glue gun to just glue it down, and I promise you it'll stay forever. But yeah, this glue is very challenging in the sense that it's very sticky and I'm literally, my hands are like gluing together. But other than that, it was a very easy project to make because the glue is like not, it works well with this material, I'd say that. So just press gently around the edges. And that's how it should look. And you're gonna wanna do this technique all the way around. So you're gonna cut off more strips and do the same thing all the way around the corners of this lid, or should I say cover, I don't know, cover, lid, the lid. So where the end, where it cuts off, make another cut and go all the way around. Glue down off camera. because I really can't touch glue and then touch my camera. It's literally sticky. So I'm gonna join this part to the other part where we left off. And as you can see, you have to get really close so it doesn't look like it cuts off. So it just looks like it keeps going round. So get really close. And also, if you're wondering why this edge around the corner is just hanging off, we're gonna cut that away. So don't worry about that. It's gonna do that. Especially if you don't measure it correctly, it's gonna do that. You might have a piece like hanging off. So we're gonna do that. And I'm gonna do that off camera. So I'm gonna cut that edge that's kind of sticking out. Sorry about the mess in the background. It's literally a lot going on with this DIY. Everything's just everywhere. And as you can see, I put too much glue. So I'm just gonna give that a few seconds before I try and attempt to press it down. So wait for it to get tacky. When it's exposed to air, it gets really tacky quickly. So just press everything in place and I'm gonna go around and cut all that excess off camera. So this is how it should look like when it's done. We've still got more to go around on the corners, but I'm just showing you how it should look like. And I cut the excess off at the bottom, so I'm just going to make sure I glue down those sides that are sticking up. But I've cut down the bottom part, and I need to cut a little bit more right there actually. But as you can see, it just looks perfect on this side, and I just have to go all the way around with some more. So off camera, I did add some crystal onto the main part of the box, and I'm gonna repeat obviously the same process we did with the lid. It's the same process we're gonna do with the actual box. And I've already done this part, and I have to cut the, you can see it sticking out at least two rows. I'm gonna cut that off camera and make sure it just blends well. And I'm just gonna glue all of this down carefully off camera. So I am now going to attach the other side of the crystal to the box. So gently you attach this, make sure then there's no bubbles. Kind of pull, if it's like slacking, like going down, slacking, just kind of pull it back up to the top. But at the same time, make sure you press out every single bubble or crease that's in here. And that's what I'm doing. Make sure the edges stick down, and as you can see at the bottom we have some left over, so we're going to cut that off as we did with the top part. We have to get all of that leftover off. There's like two rows of leftovers, and can you see how like smooth that blends in? You want it to blend in nicely, or it's going to look too cheap if it doesn't blend in. So here is what it looks like when everything is attached in place, and I'm now just gonna put the foam inside just to kind of see where everything will fit. You don't have to do this, I'm just like, for my mind to know what I'm doing, I need to just see how many pieces of foam we need in this box. And yes, you can buy foam that fits the box, I just didn't want to go to Hobby Lobby again, so I just went to Dollar Tree and just got the Dollar Tree foam. So I'm gonna put some glue down at the bottom of the box, and this is just to secure the foam. The foam actually does stay in place on its own, but I really want to secure it because I want to use this box long term, so I don't want it falling apart. So I'm just gonna put the glue down as a base. So I'm gonna put down the foam now. And I'm gonna put some more. Okay, so here I'm just kind of seeing where I want the flowers. I definitely don't want these ones. I keep trying to make that work because I like the contrast of three different tones of pinks, but it's not working. And I do like that nude pink a lot. I like how it contrasts with the dark hot pink. So I kept trying to make that other light pink work. It just wasn't light pink work, but it just wasn't working out. That yellow just threw me all the way off. So here's how it's looking, and it depends how you want. You can just choose how full you want your box to be. I'm putting the stems in, but I also do glue some of them down, especially the ones around the corner. The ones inside are secure because the ones around the corner are helping them stay there, but I'm going to be gluing the ones at the side to the box. If you want to get fullness, this is not enough for me. I want them sticking out, bursting out. So I'm going to be gluing some of those hot pink ones to the corner off camera. I glued the hot pink ones off camera to the box, the corner of the box, just so they can look like they're bursting out, like it's blooming, the flowers are just bursting out. That's the look I wanted, because it was too flat for me. And as you can see, the ones inside are just kind of hidden, and I like it that way. So it's done. Here's how it looks, dolls. I absolutely love the results. While making this video, I realized that the million roses are actually the smaller roses that are not like blooming or blossoming out. I don't know if that's the word. They're like more of the roses that look like they're on a stick, they're on the stem. So it's not a mistake. It's actually a beautiful look. I like how it looks. But if you want to see me make the DIY version with maybe white roses, I can definitely do that. I can definitely do a million roses, which are the smaller roses. I think I will do that actually, just to have some contrast. So I'll do that as well with doing this DIY all over again with that one. I can do that and just add in some pearls to it. You know, I would definitely like to do one with pearls. So let me know if you want me to do that. I am all for it, and I'll change it up a lot more than this one. But here's how it looks like. It's absolutely gorgeous, and you can put this on your beauty table with your perfumes next to it. It just screams glam and luxury, and it's never been done, and you're seeing it here first on my channel. So LB made it first. It just knocks off all the other ones that are just a plain box with the word flowers on it. I just love this a lot more, and it's definitely worth it, and it's just very inexpensive, all under $25. Why would you pay $400 for the real roses, the real box, when this one is rhinestones and diamonds or whatever, and it looks way better than the box that is $400? Because dolls, the actual box where they have the word flower on it is $400, like literally $400. They better be real roses. So but even if they're real roses, $400 is quite a lot for a million roses, right? They're not really a million, but you know. So I like mine better. I'll definitely be making more. I feel like it's such a nice thing, a centerpiece for a bridal shower, a wedding, a baby shower. Definitely whenever I get married and have my bridal shower, I'll definitely be using this in my bridal shower as a centerpiece, and have different sizes on each table. I think it's beyond beautiful, and it's so me, and it's so girly, and I encourage all of you dolls to try it out yourself. And as I said, Valentine's Day is coming up. It would make such a nice surprise and a nice gift to give to your loved ones. And it's just, especially a girl, giving this to a girl is a nice surprise on someone's birthday, you know. Just love it. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, dolls, and I'll just leave you with the clips of this. Look how sparkly it is. It's so pretty, and it's definitely a conversation piece when someone walks into your home. So thank you so much for watching. As usual, I am asking you to give this video a big fat thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and if you got to this part of the video, you definitely enjoyed it anyway. Thank you so much for watching. Give it a big fat thumbs up. If you're new to my channel and you enjoy my content, subscribe down below, and hit the notification buttons for some more projects and DIYs and videos. And thank you so much, dolls, for watching. I'd like to wish every single one of you a happy new year, a happy 2019 to come, and I wish you all your dreams come true, and so much love. Thank you so much for watching. Bye, dolls.